Hello, good evening.
Good evening, teacher. Good evening.
Evening, how are you?
Carlita. Good, teacher.
Oh, nice. It's good to see you. One more day.
Me too, teacher.
Nice. Hi, Carla.
Good evening, teacher. How are
you? Good evening. I'm very well. Thank you for asking. How are you?
I am fine.
Oh, nice. It's good to see you. I can see Azalia Melanie connected too. Hello, Azalia. She's connected, but she's doing something, I think. I see many messages on the group saying they are driving, they are working, they have problems today. Okay, how was your first day of the week? How was your Monday? ¿Cómo estuvo su lunes? How was your Monday?
Hi.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I very nice.
Was very nice.
Yes.
Excellent. I like it. Very good. And yours, Carla, how was your Monday?
Busy, teacher.
A lot of work.
Yes, the first days of the week is always busy because there are many activities that I receive during a weekend.
So everything is like accumulated.
Yes.
Oh my God, imagine. I'm sorry about that. But on Tuesday, you have less work.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I imagine. All right, how was your day, Miguel and Darwin?
Very tired.
Very tired. Very tired or very tiring? What is correct? I'm testing you. I mean, you say very tired or very tiring. What do you think is the correct form?
Tired.
Tired. No, I mean, the thing is that you are tired, Miguel. You are
yes.
Tired. But
okay.
the day was tiring with ing.
Ah, okay.
Tiring. Yes, tiring. Mainly in these cases, when you use an adjective to describe something, you use ing. Like the movie was exciting or the movie was interesting. But when you describe your emotions, you use ed. Like I was interested in the movie. Because the movie was interesting, okay?
Okay.
Or I was excited about the movie. Ah, because the movie was exciting, okay? Yeah.
Okay, teacher, thank you.
It's only a little tip, not only for you, but for everybody, okay? For everybody, these things are important for everybody. Okay, let's see. Oh, I see more people connected in this moment. So Darwin, the fisherman. Darwin is the fisherman. What is fisherman, Darwin? What is fisherman?
Pescador.
Pescador. So Darwin is a fisherman.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Very good. It's good. It's good to know that. A rato me hace la invitación para ir a pescar ahí por esa zona. To go fishing in your area.
Okay. Aquí está in the river is the agua caliente.
Agua caliente. But it's like, where is that exactly? It's near the sea, or está cerca del mar, o más arriba, or how, where is it? No.
No, it's no more ocean. It's a large distance.
Ah, okay. It's far. You say it's far. It's far from the sea. It's far from the sea.
It's far from the sea.
Okay, I
está
see.
Cerca de Termos del Río.
Oh, cerca de Termos del Río.
Yes.
París Lampa River.
No, de Agua Caliente.
Oh, it's Agua Caliente River. Wow, oh, okay. All right, very good. So it's a small river or it's a big river? Small or big?
It's a small river.
It's a small river. Okay, good. Yes. Excellent. Very good. Okay, so I see more people connected now. I see Zulma, Gloria, Mayra, yeah, Nelson, Oscar, Lourdes, Margarita. Oh, I didn't see Margarita on Friday. Hi, Margarita. Margarita, hello. Well, so let's start then. Okay, so
hello,
and welcome.
Thanks.
I didn't see you on Friday.
Yes, teacher, because this day turn off the light.
You say you can say we had no electricity or we didn't have. We didn't have electricity.
We didn't have electricity.
Electricity
in
exactly.
My house.
Oh, I see. I'm sorry.
A little moment, mm-hmm. But later I couldn't connect.
Oh, nice. Oh, no, not nice. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry you couldn't connect. All right, so let's start. So good evening, everybody. So I hope everyone is okay. So it's time to start the class. And I will start with the attendance in this moment, okay? So we have Ada Patricia here. Ada?
Listen.
All right, Adriana?
Listen.
Adriana?
Present, teacher.
Okay, all right. Ana Michelle?
Present.
Very good. Angela?
Present, teacher.
Azalia?
Present. Good evening.
Good evening. Darwin?
Present, teacher.
All right. Flor? Flor was texting on the group, right? Gloria?
Here.
All right, excellent. Carla?
Present.
Great. Margarita? Margarita?
Present.
All right. Mayra?
Present.
Nice. Miguel?
Present, teacher.
Very good. Nelson? Nelson? Ophelia? Osmin?
Present, teacher.
Very good. Rafael? Rosa? Sandra? Yancy?
Present.
Yeah, Zulma?
Present.
Edwin? Ingrid? Lourdes?
Present, teacher.
Yeah, I saw Lourdes. Yeah, thank you, Lourdes. Oscar?
Present.
And Susana? Los que están ahorita, más que todo Lourdes y Oscar, ¿saben acerca de Ingrid? Ella estaba con ustedes en algún grupo, ¿no?
No la recuerdo.
Ah, ok. Sí, es que ella ninguna vez se ha conectado. ¿Edwin?
Edwin, sí.
Edwin, sí. Ok, es que solo se conectó el primer día y no la he visto conectada uh-huh. otra vez. Ajá. Y también uh-huh. Susana, que se conecta así de vez. Así no toda la clase. Ok, muy bien. So let's thank you very much. So let's start then today's class. And for today's class, we have a variety of activities, of course. And we will finish with the topic would be or could be, right? Would be or could be for possibility. Ok. So just one quick reminder. Solo un recordatorio rápido. Ok, just a quick reminder. Remember that today or this week, the deadline for the activities of week number one is Wednesday, okay? La fecha límite para la entrega de tareas de la primera semana es el miércoles. It's Wednesday, all right? So please remember that we started on Thursday. So Thursday, Friday, then we have Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday is day number 5, okay? So the deadline is Wednesday. Así que la fecha límite para la entrega de la primera semana es el miércoles. It's on Wednesday before the class, okay? Before the session. Okay, so please keep it in mind. Llévenlo en mente. Keep it in mind, please, all right? It's just a reminder. I told you, but I repeat it because it's important. Okay, no problem. So let's start with today's session then. And I remember in the last class, okay, on Friday, we started a little bit of would be and could be, all right? Would be and could be. And we have two examples, okay? Example here, would be. I would be a great asset. Do you remember this sentence in Spanish? I would be a great asset. What does it mean in Spanish? Do you remember the meaning of the sentence in Spanish? I would be a great asset. Sería?
Debería.
Debería. I would say sería. Sería what? Sería un gran... Empleado, okay. I would be a great asset. Sería un buen empleado. So would be. Now let's look at the second example. I could be of great help in the sales department. How do you say this in Spanish?
Sería de gran ayuda en el departamento de ventas.
Maybe in this case, the translation in Spanish
is different.
Podría ser de gran ayuda en el departamento de ventas. So could be is podría ser. And would be is sería. All right. Would be sería. Could be podría ser. But it's the same purpose. Yes. Okay. It's the same purpose. Es el mismo propósito. It's the same purpose. To indicate an impression of possibility. All right. Good. For example, I can say, oh, I would be a great architect. I would be a great architect because I like drawings, for example. Or I would be a good mathematics teacher in my case because I like numbers, okay? I would be a great secretary. Why? Because I can type really fast. Or you can say I could be a great secretary, okay? Good. So in this case, we use would be and could be to indicate an impression of possibility, right? So do you have any question about this? It's very easy, right? The structure, la estructura, the structure is first we use the the subject. First the subject, okay? The subject and then? And then what? And then what? Would be or could be, right? Would be or? Could be, okay? This is the structure, or could be. Es la estructura, could be, plus the verb, plus the complement. Example, I could be, for example, I could be what? Oh, here, here we don't have a verb, sorry. Aquí no hay verbo, sorry, okay? I'm sorry about that, okay? Here we don't have a verb, here. Okay, I'm sorry about that. So only say and the complement. I could be, for example, a great teacher, okay? Because I like children, okay? I could be a great teacher because I like children, for example, okay? So the structure is subject, could be or would be, and the complement, okay? So that's the structure. Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. Now, do you have any questions? Any question? That topic is very easy, but do you have any question? No? No questions? No. Very clear, right? And very easy. All right. So since you don't have questions, the idea right now is that you organize these sentences. All right?
All right.
Yeah?
Yeah.
For example, let's do number one together. How do you think number one together would stay? Check number one.
It would be
a great opportunity to study.
It would be a great opportunity to study abroad is like in another country. Okay, so it would be a great opportunity to study abroad. All right, so these sentences are on page number 12, okay? So these sentences are on page number 12, all right? So please, You will work in pairs, okay? In pairs, you will organize the words to make the sentences, okay? So in pairs, okay? Complete this activity in pairs, all right? So I will give you like 5 minutes, all right, for this activity. So let's go to work in pairs. Let's go to work in pairs.
Vaya. ¿Usted tiene el libro en digital, Adriana?
No, físico.
Vaya. Ah, vaya. Ahorita lo veo.
Pero puedo compartir pantalla también, porque soy de...
Ah,
la
vaya, porfa.
Va.
Y yo soy desde mi teléfono y lo estaba.
Ya.
Así, organize the sentence.
Ah, muy bien.
Okay.
La primera dice
it will be a great opportunity to study abroad.
To study abroad, correcto. Ahora la dos.
Second, oh yes.
Our will be. No.
The subject? The subject first?
Our.
Our employees? No. Our employees could be. Mm-hmm.
Our clients could be a beneficial. Could be a training for beneficial.
A training for beneficial.
For beneficial.
Okay.
Tres.
Number three.
Check number two again, please.
Okay.
Check number two again. I feel there's something. Yeah.
Check number two again. Could be a train for beneficio. Nuestros empleados pueden entrenarse capacitarse.
Mm-hmm.
Al revés sería.
Yeah,
a
beneficial for training.
Close. That's closer. Estamos cerca. That's closer. The subject is a training.
Ah.
The subject is a training, okay?
Okay, entonces a training
for employees will be a beneficial.
A training
for
our employees. Let's see.
Will be beneficial.
This is correct, teacher.
Much better, but it's not the correct form. It's much better. It's much better, but it's not the correct form. Maybe think a little bit. It's okay.
Training for our employer could be a beneficial.
Mm-hmm. No, it's okay. A training for employees could be beneficial. Ah, no, it's correct. Leave it like that. It makes sense. All right. Leave it like that. It's correct.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Next.
Yes, ours, another working will be beneficial. Benefit. Okay.
Less hour, the subject less hour, no. less hour
working. No.
Less hour will be. Less hour. Menos horas podrían ser.
No sería another less hour.
Another.
Benefit is a verb in this case, I think. Ah, no, it's a noun, sorry. It's a noun. Benefit is a noun in this case.
I think is another less hour.
Mm-hmm.
Working.
Think a little.
It's complicated, teacher.
That's the idea. The idea is that you think, okay? So take your time to think.
Benefit.
Okay.
Staff will be.
Staff will be happy.
Staff will be a weekend off to have.
A good option.
Happy.
es que yo creo que es algo así. En español se lo voy a decir para que entienda mi idea.
Uh-huh.
El staff podría estar feliz si tiene la opción de tener libres, fines de semana libres. O sea, si tiene esa buena opción de tener algo así.
Think in English. If you think in Spanish, you will mess it up, all right? Think in English.
Why? In what moment?
I am spying you like... All right, continue.
Okay. Staff will be happy.
Or maybe, no. Good staff will be happy to have an option. No. Oh my God. So difficult.
Let me give you a little push.
Yes, please.
I think need more options.
The subject is weekends off. So you start the sentence by saying weekends off.
No necessary is a subject, right?
No. I mean, in this case, weekends off would be the subject. Uh-huh. Weekends off.
For example, in the number three, working is the subject.
Okay. Let me see. Exactly. Uh-huh. So a gerund is the subject.
Uh-huh. Weekend offs will be. Weekend offs will be. Options.
A good option.
Weekend offs will be a good option to have a good staff.
Thanks, teacher.
but to have a good staff, but you don't have a staff. Oh yeah, you have a staff, right? I'm sorry.
Yes.
Right? Let me see.
No. Weekend offs will be
a good option.
To have a happy staff. Exactly.
Okay.
Hi, teacher.
Weekends.
We are good students.
You are great students.
Oh, we cannot.
To have a happy staff.
Pero el chiste es sustituido por María, que es ella.
Ajá, sí, sí, claro. She could be head.
No. Of great, creo que quizás sea.
She could be. Ay, no.
Which number?
Four
or five. In which are you working? In number four or in number five?
Both, but teacher.
Both, four and five. Yeah. Okay, so say
now
number
five. Maria could be. Maria could be help in the inventory department.
But you are missing grade.
Ah, okay. Maria.
Ah, of grade. Okay. Yes, repeated. Repeated, Jancy, is correct. The form you said is correct. Repeat it, please. María.
Ah, María could be of great help in inventory.
In the inventory department. That before inventory, uh-huh. Okay? In the inventory department, all right?
Number four.
Say it, please. Say what you have.
Another will be benefit working hour.
I mean, number four.
Number four. Yeah. Staff will be.
The subject in this case is weekends off. You start the sentence with weekends off. Okay, now continue. All right. Fines de semana libres. Okay, weekends off.
Weekends off will be.
Yeah.
I don't know, teacher.
Yeah, you're doing good. Continue. Weekends off would be. Continue thinking. Take your time. And try to make the sentence.
Weekends off will be.
Una palabra para poderle dar sentido a la oración. Teacher, ayúdenos.
Ya.
Nos falta una palabra para darle sentido a la oración.
The fourth sentence.
Say it, please.
Uh-huh, number.
Uh-huh. Say it, please. Say it. Say the sentence.
Es que allí donde no sabemos cómo formularla, porque podría ser a good option.
No, you start the sentence with weekends off. You start the sentence with weekends off. So the first or the subject is weekends off. Yeah, that's the first.
Weekends off. Okay. Would be.
Continue. And in number three, you better say working less hours would be another benefit. Okay, in number three. Working less hours would be another benefit.
Hours.
Yeah, that's right. So in number four, the subject is weekends off, all right? Would be, weekends and then you off. Continue, all right? Weekends off could be.
Okay.
Entonces. Weekend off
would be.
Now continue, please.
Weekends off would be.
Ahí cabe una. A good
to have for
Hello, teacher.
Hello.
Training. Okay. Mm-hmm.
another.
Teacher, teníamos dudas con la number four.
You have doubts in number four. Read it, please. Leana, read it, please, because I don't see it very well. No la veo muy bien.
Weekend off will be a good option to have a happy staff.
Perfect.
Ah, yay!
No nos hacía sentido.
Ajá.
Yeah, that's the way. That's the way. That's the best way.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Repeat. Working. Yes, of course. Weekend. Weekend. Oh. Be a good option to have a happy staff. Maria Kubi, Maria. Oh, we oh, in the inventory department. Vale, la hora de...
Entonces sería AHAP. ¿Cómo quedaría AHAP?
Teacher, estamos algo perdidos.
Hello.
Hay que aceptarlo.
The sentence is no subject.
They have a subject. The problem is that you don't see the subject.
No hallamos la segunda, nos pasamos a la tercera, y como la tercera medio la encontramos, nos pasamos a la cuarta.
En number,
está complicado.
En number four is more difficult than number one. All right, so you completed number one.
And number one is...
In number two?
It will be a great opportunity to study abroad.
And in number two, what do you have?
Second.
Yeah, on the second.
Or employees.
No, you started the sentence. No, you started the sentence with a training. A training is the subject. So the first phrase in the sentence is a training.
Oh, a training.
Yes.
Training.
Now try to make the sentence using a training.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Entonces sería a training.
A training is the subject. So you say a training following the structure could be, right?
Could be.
Could be what?
A training.
Could be. Could be.
Could be.
Could be ahorita, please.
Or employees.
Mm.
Or beneficial no, employees.
Beneficial. And then?
Or employees.
For our. You have our, for our employees. Okay? A training could be beneficial for our employees. Employees.
Employees.
Exactly.
Number three, teacher.
What do you
another
have?
Another working.
You start with working. You start with working. Working and then?
Solo working.
Working is the subject. Working is the subject. Working.
So mother. It's working. Working will be.
No, but you have something else with working. Ahí va algo más con working.
Working Another.
Think. Think for a moment. Piensa por un momentito. Te voy a dar un minuto más. I will give you one more minute.
Let's less hours.
Working less hours. Yeah, it's okay. Working less hours. It's okay.
Working is a subject.
Working less hours is the subject. Working less hours. Trabajar menos horas.
Would be another benefit.
Exactly. You can have two options. You have two options in this one. You can say working less hours will be another benefit. Or you can say another benefit would be working less hours. Two options, okay? Yes.
Number four, staff.
Here you start with weekends. The subject here is weekends off. Weekends off is the subject. Fines de semana libres, weekends off. Now continue.
Weekend off will be.
Continue. Could be. Would be.
Will be. Will be.
It's okay. Have no. Weekends off would be
a option.
It's okay, but before option, you need something. Antes de option, va algo más.
Two.
Sorry?
Two options.
No, no.
A good.
A good, exactly. So weekends off would be a good option.
A good option. To happy.
To have, no, to. The verb. To. To, which verb do you have? To have. To have, not to have. Okay. I know it was a little complicated. I know it was a little complicated because the sentences are a bit long. Okay, the sentences are a bit long, but don't worry, okay? We are going to check together. Okay, let's see. Let's check first number one. Who wants to share number one? Number one? Who wants to share? ¿Quién quiere compartir? Who wants to share?
Me, teacher. Me,
okay,
teacher.
Miguel, yes. Share number one.
Number one. It will be a great opportunity to study abroad.
Excellent. All right. Thank you very much, Miguel. It would be a great opportunity to study abroad, to study in another country, okay? To study in another country, out of my country. Good. Number two, who wants to share number two?
Me.
Me, teacher.
Okay, let's see Oscar, and then we listen to Adriana with number three. Okay, Oscar, number two.
Okay, a training for our employees could be beneficial.
A training for our employees could be beneficial. Good. Do we have another option? Thank you, Oscar. Do we have another option? Oscar
me
says.
Teacher.
Okay, let me see, Carla.
A training could be beneficial for our employees.
Yes, two options, right? So a training for our employees or a training could be beneficial for our employees. Two options, okay?
Employees.
So I repeat the options. A training for our employees could be beneficial or a training could be beneficial for our employees, all right? So thank you very much, Carla and Oscar, okay? Now, Adriana, number three.
Working less hours will be another benefit.
That's right. Working less hours would be another benefit. Excellent. Thank you very much. That's really good. Let's see number four. Who wants to do number four? Number four, volunteers?
Me, teacher.
All right, Margarita. Number four.
Weekends off will be a good option to have a happy staff.
But you say will be or would be, Margarita? Margarita, will be or would be?
Weekends off will be.
Would. Yeah, I mean, it's okay. The whole structure is correct, but it's would be or will be? Would be, right? Maybe. Would be. Would. Okay, mm-hmm. Would be. Because we are using would be and could be, okay? Yeah? Okay, Margarita. Repeat,
please,
Margarita. Repeat it, please,
Margarita. Okay. Weekends off will be a good option to have a happy staff.
Excellent. That's very good. Thank you, Margarita. So that's excellent. So weekends off would be a good option to have happy staff. Okay. Thank you, Margarita. And let's see number five. Who has number five? Who has number five? Number five, volunteers. Okay, let's see.
Me, teacher.
Margarita wants to and Carla, but Margarita and Carla participated. So thank you very much. I appreciate your participation. Okay, but I want to listen to another person here. Thank you very much. So any other volunteers besides Margarita and Carla? Lourdes. All right, Lourdes. Yes. Thank you very much. Okay, read it for the class.
Okay, Maria could be great help in the department of inventory.
All right, Maria could be great help in the department of inventory. It makes sense, yes. Actually. Okay, thank you. Do we have another option? Thank you, Lourdes. Who has another option? Nobody has another option? No. Okay, then let's listen to Carla. Carla wants to share. Okay, Carla, can you share what you have?
Okay. Maria could be of great help in the inventory department.
Okay, that's better. Okay, thank you very much. So that's the correct one. Okay, that's Carla's yes. Answer is the correct one. Repeat it for everybody, please, Carla.
Maria could be of great help in the inventory department.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, so basically those are the answers. Okay, so thank you everyone. I know that not everyone's answers were correct, but everyone worked and everyone thought. Okay, that's the most important. So thank you very much for taking the time. Oh, by the way, we have Ingrid connected. So Ingrid is introducing herself. So welcome, Ingrid. Bienvenida, Ingrid. Welcome.
I'm first day, teacher.
Yeah, okay. It's good to see you here. Es bueno verte por acá. It's good to see you here. So welcome. Bienvenida. We don't hear you,
I'm
Ingrid.
New, teacher.
You're new, yeah. So welcome, bienvenida. Yes, I know you are new, so thank welcome. You. Bienvenida. Welcome to the group. Bienvenida al grupo. Okay, so let's carry on. So listen.
Teacher. In the...
Yeah.
Teacher. Yes, Carla. En la número cuatro, yo estuve. En number four, I write in the activity. In the activity two online. But it's wrong. I don't know what is the correct. Instruction
in number four.
Yes.
Are you share it in the group, right? Tú la compartiste en el grupo. No.
No. Yo estaba, como estas son parte de la tarea, las iba haciendo de una sola vez, pero la número cuatro, así como la dijo Margarita, tampoco no me sale bien. Yo no la pude hacer. Margarita escribió weekend. Off will be a good option.
A happy staff.
No la agarra.
Okay, okay. So try another one then. Maybe you can have to have happy employees. Weekends off would be a good option. Intenten esa, tal vez le funcione. Y me dicen luego, okay? So you can say then. To have happy employees, weekends off would be a good option. Just to see if it works, para ver si funciona, to see if it works, okay? And then you let me know later. Okay, in the meantime, let's go to the next activity. So listen, in the next activity, we have, let me share here. Well, I guess I can explain it like this. Now, pay attention carefully here. Pay attention carefully. Now listen, in the next activity, imagine, use your imagination. Let your imagination fly, all right? Imagine you are going to work in a new company. I repeat, imagine you are going to work in a new company, all right? So the thing here is that you think, okay, why you would be of great benefit to that company, or why you could be of great benefit to that company. ¿Por qué serían un gran beneficio para esa compañía? So you are going to work in a new company. Why would you be a great benefit to that company? All right? So basically, you need to talk about your abilities. For example, I work in a school, right? I work in a school. But using my imagination, in my new job, I want to work in a university. I want to work in a university. So what would be the benefits the university would get, I mean, from me, all right, from me? So I can say, for example, I would be of great help to the university because I am an experienced teacher, for example. It's only one example, right? So I repeat, I would be of great benefit to the university because I have a lot of experience, okay? And also, I could be of great help because I know many people from the United States, for example. I know many native speakers, okay? For example, right? Yeah, so the idea is that you explain your reasons, not my reasons, your reasons why you would be of great benefit to the new company, right? Do you get it? Está más o menos claro? It's kind of clear? Kind of clear?
Yes.
Yes, right? So,
yes.
The idea is that you use would be or could be. La idea es que usen would be and could be. Y could be, right? Para explicar por qué serían de gran beneficio para esa nueva compañía que lo va a contratar. Okay? It's about your abilities, basically. Puede ser about your abilities, about your experience. Okay? Yeah? And maybe you can write like two or three sentences. Pueden escribir dos o tres oraciones. ¿Por qué debe contratarlos esa empresa? Okay? ¿Estamos claros? Are we clear?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
The idea is that you use would be and could be, okay? Would be and could be. Imagine you want to work in a bakery. I don't know, I'm just using my imagination. En una panadería. And then you say, oh, I would be of great help to the bakery because I can make different types of bread, for example, okay? Or imagine you will be a supervisor of that company. You will be a supervisor, okay? You say, I consider, maybe you can say, or I think I would be a great supervisor to the company because I can work with people or I can work in teams, you can say, right? I'm just giving you examples. Okay, just write two or three examples, okay? Two or three examples, no more. Two or three examples. Ingrid, para que tengas una mejor idea en lo que estamos, básicamente estamos en la página 12, ¿ok? En la página 12 ahí está un cuadrito y ahí está el temita explicado del would be y el could be, ¿ok? Ahí para que tengas una mejor idea, porque yo sé que recientemente, ahorita te estás agregando, para que tengas una idea de lo que van a hacer, ¿ok?
Sí, creo que estaba buscando.
Sí, está en la página 12. It's on page number 12.
Y con estas otras dos clases que no he estado para lo de la tarea, ¿cómo puedo hacer?
Si gustas, me escribes luego, pero igual la puedes completar. El miércoles se cierra la tarea de la semana. Así que tienes hasta el miércoles para completar las tareas. Igual, si ya faltaron dos días, básicamente como que ya están en el límite del 80% de asistencia, ¿ok? Perdón, del 20% que pueden faltar. Así que la idea es que de aquí en adelante, que ya no faltes. Okay. Sería lo ideal, ¿ok?
Ok. ¿Verdad que si me ubico mejor, el I call y el I will es el yo podría y el yo puedo? No me recuerdo ahorita muy bien eso. No sé si me
equivoco. Ajá. Normalmente se usa el would be y el could be. Would be sería yo sería, ¿ok? I would be, for example, I would be a great secretary. Yo sería una buena secretaria, una gran secretaria. I would be. Y el could be is like podría ser. Yo podría ser. I could be, yo podría ser. ¿Perdón? ¿Sorry?
En términos futuros.
Exactamente, es una posibilidad futura. Uh-huh. It's a future possibility.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Es para dar una impresión de posibilidad de que yo soy un buen candidato, digamos en este caso, para lo que me van a contratar.
Uh-huh. Okay. Ajá. O sea que tengo que usar ahorita las dos palabras.
Exactamente.
El I could be y el could be.
Uh-huh. Maybe you can write one sentence using I would be y una usando I could be. Ajá, una y una. One and one. All right. Just remember, the idea is that you are going to work in a different company, okay? Not your company. It's in a new company, right? In another company. And they need to see your abilities, okay, for that company. Or what you are going to contribute to that company, right? So you say, I would be. Ustedes están convenciendo a esa compañía de por qué serían los mejores en eso, okay? You are convincing the company, all right? So please, when you finish, go to reactions and raise your hand, okay? Cuando terminen, vayan a reacciones, tus reactions, y ponen la manita levantada para ver más o menos cuántos han terminado, okay? To see how many people have finished, please, okay? Do me that favor, please. Okay, I'll give you 2 more minutes, all right? I'll give you 2 more minutes. I can see Margarita and Adriana finished, okay? Thank you for raising hands, Margarita and Adriana. Thank you very much. Oh, and Lourdes too. Thank you, Lourdes. Oh, and Rosa, thank you. I will pass you the attendance while you continue working, okay? So please continue working and I will pass you the attendance, okay? Ada?
Here.
Adriana?
Present.
Very good. Ana Michelle?
Present.
Very good. Angela?
Present, teacher.
Azalia?
I am here, teacher.
Very good. Darwin?
Present, teacher.
Excellent. Flor?
Present.
All right. Thank you. Gloria?
Here.
Very good. Carla?
Present.
Nice. Margarita?
Present.
Mayra?
Present.
Miguel?
Present, teacher.
Nelson?
Present, teacher.
Okay. Ofelia?
Here, teacher.
Osmin?
Present, teacher.
Rafael?
Present.
Rosa?
Present.
Sandra?
Sandra? Present.
Okay.
Present.
Okay. Jancy?
Present.
Zulma?
Here.
Edwin? Edwin, Ingrid?
Present.
Very good. Lourdes?
Present, teacher.
Okay.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Oscar?
Present.
Susana? Okay, thank you very much. Okay, are you ready? ¿Están listos? Are you ready?
Yes,
teacher. Yes, or almost ready, or kind of ready, or okay. Let's see. If I guess at least you need to have one benefit. At least, okay. At least you need to have one benefit. Okay. So if you have one benefit, no problem. Okay, you can share that benefit. If you have 2 or 3 benefits, no problem. You can share. All right. So listen. The idea in this moment is that we go to breakout rooms in groups. And in the groups, you need to convince your classmates that you are the ideal asset for that company. Okay? I repeat. In the groups, you need to convince your classmates that you are the ideal employee or the ideal asset for that company, okay? So don't say, for example, I will give you one example. Don't say, for example, I think I would be a great asset for the company. No, okay, that's not convincing. Eso no es convincente, all right? So you need to say like very secure, okay, very secure. Oh, I think I would be a great asset for this company because I am a great teacher, all right? So with feeling. But if you say, I think I would be a great, no, all right, no. Be convincing, all right? Sean convincentes. You are going to convince your classmates, all right? Ahorita van a convencer a sus compañeros. Convince your classmates. So your classmates will decide if they give you the job, all right? Ellos van a decidir si les dan el trabajo o no. They will decide if they will give you the job, all right? Yeah? So be convincing, please. Sean convincentes. Be convincing, please, all right? Is it clear? Is the instruction clear? Yeah. Yes. So please take turns in the groups. Tomen turnos. Take turns in the groups. All right. So let's go then. Let's go and share. Okay, let's go and share.
¿Por qué el trabajo?
Alguien, si quiere pueden desconectar and disconnect your microphone, please, and only on when you talk, please. Yes. Voy a start. Okay, Gloria.
Okay. Okay, Rafael. ¿Cuál es la pregunta que le voy a hacer también? ¿Es por qué quiere usted trabajar en la empresa, verdad? Esa es la pregunta. ¿O cómo? Espera.
No, there's no question, Gloria. Gloria. No, there's no question. You only listen to your classmates and your human resources, and you decide, okay?
Okay.
All right?
All right. Okay, Rafael.
Sorry, our group, we listen to you. You have talking for all group.
Bueno, I could be increase my work productivity. Number one. Number two, I could be ¿cómo se pronuncia? Desarrollar. ¿Cómo se pronuncia?
Develop
my ability to work in a team. And number three, I could be committed to the company.
Committed in this case, committed to the company. I could be committed to the company. Yes.
Okay.
Oh, la van a contratar? Are you going? So Rafa, Ada, and Ophelia, are you going to hire her? Or you will give her a second chance? O le van a dar una segunda oportunidad después. You will give her a second chance?
Yes.
A second chance?
¿Cómo se dice contratada, teacher?
Hired. You can say you're hired. Estás contratada. You are hired. Yeah.
Who's next?
Next. Ustedes. No, Rafael, usted es el caballero
para tu compañero.
La escuché porque venía el teacher. Es que hace un ruido. Recording en qué dice teacher, cada vez que uno entra, entonces cuando usted está hablando, ese teacher.
Ahí dice.
Excuse me, teacher.
Dice listos, ahí viene el teacher.
No, it says recording in progress. Ok, grabación en proceso.
Recording en
progreso. En progreso, perdón, in progress, en progreso.
Pero antes no hacía, no podía estar observando usted y no nos damos cuenta. Ahora sí sabemos cuándo está y cuándo
es de los módulos para acá que ha entrado eso.
Cierto.
Uh-huh. Qué bueno, yeah. Porque no nos dábamos cuenta y ahora sí.
Okay, ok, señorita Salia, sí. Please.
Sí, siempre me dejan a mí cuando viene el teacher, está bien. Ok. Mejor Zulma. Escondida, Zulma.
Hola.
Hello, chicas.
Hola, sí voy. Yo puse I would be good to coordinating projects. I could be good elements because I have experience in business intelligence, and I could be of great help in the financial department. Only that.
Yo no hice las oraciones, pero sí puse. Okay. I could contribute my ideas, my knowledge and experience. It will be great to be able to demonstrate my capabilities in the performance of my whole.
Capacities. But you better say abilities. I think in this case, you better say abilities.
Abilities.
Mm-hmm.
Habilidades.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
So human resources.
Que nos den trabajo.
Will you give her a second chance? ¿La van a contratar o le van a dar una segunda oportunidad?
Yes.
So you say, you're hired. You are
sería
hired.
Una good assistant.
Either you say, I would be a great assistant. I would be
a
great assistant. Yeah. But say like, I would be a great assistant for your company. All right, like, I would be a great assistant
in your company.
Yes, better, much better.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Okay.
Okay.
Angie, ¿la quieren escuchar, teacher?
Ah, a mí, Mimi. Es que les decía que yo no me puse que yo de mis habilidades, sino que las terceras personas. You could be of great benefit to the company for your experience. Es correcto. Experience. She should be at the manager meeting. And we should be more attentive in the trainings. They could be sales manager because of the skill. That's it.
The structure is okay, Angela, but the idea was that you talked about your abilities, about your qualifications, okay? Because the idea was to hire you, okay? La idea era contratarla por, no contratar al somebody else, not to hire somebody else, but to hire you, right? Yeah, okay. So maybe you can change and you can say I. Don't say she or you say I. I could be a great asset because I have experience, for example, okay?
Yes, I could be of the great benefit to the company for your experience.
Exactly.
For my experience.
Yeah.
I should be at the manager's meeting.
Your turn.
Okay. Again, if I wanted to work in a publishing house, I think I could be a book publisher, a good book publisher, because I like to read and I consider that I will be good at detecting errors in writing.
Yes.
Higher. Okay. Higher. 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 Contratada, higher. You are higher.
Higher.
Okay. Okay. I could be the best employee in your business, in your business, because I have a lot of experience in the financial department. Also, I would be a great element in the work team because I'm a good person with moral and ethical values. Since I could be very skillful with Microsoft Office and another accounting programs. Teacher, is another, is another or other?
For plural, you say other. So you say other accounting programs because it's plural. Other. For plural is other, and for singular is another. Okay.
Okay. Another. Ingrid, your turn.
Yes. Okay, hey boy. Ay, permita. So, ya me quedé. Ay. No les, no les escucho, no les escucho. No se ve. Ah. Hey, teacher. I'll listen, teacher.
Yes.
Se fue.
Yeah, she left. I think, creo que ahorita que puse la opción de que ya, ya podían salir, se salió. She accepted, I think.
Okay.
She was very strategic, right?
Very intelligent.
Yeah. Por la campana.
Very smart. Very smart.
Teacher, me sacó, me salí.
I think you accepted because the thing is that I gave you an extra minute. Okay, le di un minuto extra, pero yo creo que por error tal vez presionaste en salir. Okay, no permitiste que terminara el minuto. No, but it's okay, no problem, don't worry. Casi no se te escucha.
Se me trabó cortado el teléfono, entonces quería. Ajá, es que eso yo les escuchaba cortado, entonces yo apretaba para ver qué y me salí, no sé si me salí o me o se terminó, no sé.
Yes, you exited. Sorry. Te saliste. Yes, but it's okay, don't worry. Okay, everyone. So I guess everybody practiced, right? I don't know how many people were hired. No sé a cuántos contrataron. I don't know how many people were hired, all right? But the idea was to do it with feeling, right? With feeling, not like very like depressed or something, okay? The idea was to do it with feeling, all right? By the way, I have a question for everyone, okay? How do you say estás contratado in English?
You are hired.
You are hired, exactly. Say you are hired, okay? I will write it for everybody, all right? It's like this. It's like this. You are, like, I will use the construction, okay? You're hired, all right? Estás contratado. O estás contratada, you're hired, all right? You're hired. So if you want to write it, you can take notes. Okay, very good. Basically, just summarizing, okay, just summarizing, summing up. The idea was to use, the idea in this activity was to use would be and could be, all right? Just don't forget that you say, I would be of great help, for example, or I could be a great candidate, for example, or I could be a great manager, or I could be a great supervisor, all right? Very commonly, you use great. Okay, very frequently you use the word great or good, all right? I would be a good employee, for example, or I would be a good engineer, all right? For this or that, yeah? Okay, so do you have any question about this topic or it's clear? Have you got any question about this topic? Would be and could be, or it's okay, no problem?
No problem.
No problem, everything clear. Okay, very good. So you can go and practice now. Sorry?
I am hired, teacher.
You were hired. Oh, congratulations. Excellent. All right, congratulations. Very good.
For floor.
Wow, floor hired you. For how many years? 1 year or 2 years or 3 years? How long?
He's manager.
For manager, but for how long? Is the contract, para cuánto es el contrato, for how long is the contract? 2 years or?
1 year.
1 year, too short. All right, very good. So let's carry on. So in the next part, I have a PowerPoint presentation here. And on this PowerPoint, I have two questions, all right? On this PowerPoint, I have two questions. So question number one is, how long have you worked in your company? How long have you worked in your company, all right? ¿Por cuánto tiempo has trabajado en tu compañía? How long have you worked in your company? In the answer, you say, I have worked in my company for, yo he trabajado en mi compañía por, you can say maybe for 2 years, for 5 years, for 1 week, for 2 months, for half a year, for 20 years, I don't know, all right? So it's, this is personal, right? So the question is, how long have you worked in your company? Question number two, have you occupied different positions? ¿Has ocupado diferentes posiciones o trabajos? Oh, you can say, yes, I have, okay? I have been is like yo he sido, I have been, yo he sido. I have been a manager, a supervisor, a CEO, I don't know, right? So there you say your answers, okay? So please take a moment and answer the two questions, please. Take a moment and answer the two questions. If you want, make a screenshot. Si quieren, les hacen una captura de pantalla. If you want, make a screenshot, okay? Para que tengan las preguntas luego. Oh, by the way, ¿a quién le toca ahora la sesión 1-on-1? Who has the one-on-one session today? Who, me?
Me, Michelle.
Ah, okay, Michelle. Very good. See you at 10 then. See you at 10. In question number one, you only need to say the years, right? You have worked, los años o los meses que han trabajado, the years or the months you have worked for that company, okay? And in number two, just I have or no, I haven't, right? If you say no, I haven't, you don't have to write anything else. No deben escribir nada más si dicen no, I haven't. In number two, okay?
Teacher, yep. What is the form correct?
What is?
I have short time or I have little time?
Little. You better say little.
Okay.
But tell me the complete sentence, please.
Okay. I have little time in the company.
You better say, oh my God. Short. In this case, I have a short time working in the company. Okay.
Working in the company.
Yes.
How long have?
Teacher, ¿qué es lo que tenemos que hacer ahorita? Porque me desconecté. Se me cayó el internet.
Yeah, you will answer the two questions. Vamos a contestar las dos preguntas. And you have the structure here to answer. Aquí está la estructura para responder. So question number one is, how long have you worked in the company, all right? ¿Cuánto tiempo has trabajado en tu compañía? And then the answer, I have worked in my company for 2 years, for 1 year, for 2 months, I don't know, all right? And the second question, have you occupied different positions? ¿Has ocupado diferentes posiciones? You say, yes, I have. I have been a secretary, a supervisor, blah, blah, blah. Okay, las diferentes posiciones que han tenido en la compañía, the different positions in the company, okay?
Okay, okay, okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Okay. I guess everybody made the screenshots, right? Creo que todos hicieron ya la captura para poder salirme de acá. Yes? Si no la han hecho, hagan la captura de pantalla, por favor. If you haven't made a screenshot, please make a screenshot so you have the questions. I'll give you 2 more minutes, all right? 2 minutos más, 2 more minutes. Okay, Rafa, can you tell me a consonant, please?
Okay.
Rafa, can you tell me a consonant?
Sí.
Sí, all right. Let me see. Sí, letter C.
Teacher, ¿cómo se puede decir cuando no es un, o sea, no son años enteros, sino que son año y medio?
Maybe you can say, in this case, if it's año y medio, you can say 1 year and a half. 1 year and a half. A half. A half, exactly. So let's see the participations we are going to have. Let's see. Rafael said letter C, right? Let's see letter C. Oh my God, I don't see any letter C's here. Rivas. No letter C's. Tell me another one, another consonant, please, Rafael. Quickly, don't look at your classmates.
M.
M, all right, let me see. M. So Mayra, you will participate for this activity. Mayra, Michelle. Okay, you will participate for this activity, Michelle. Let me see, Melanie. You too. All right, let me see. Who else? Miguel? Miguel, you will participate. Let me see who else. Rosa, Flor de Maria, sorry. Flor de Maria. All right, let me see. Who else? Ingrid? You are Magali? Okay, Ingrid, you will participate too. Margarita too, Margarita, Margarita, yes, Ingrid, second name, so Margarita too, okay, Magali, all right, Margarita, you will participate, and yeah, basically esta, just them, sorry?
Y esta segunda pregunta se refiere más que todo a posiciones dentro de la empresa o a las posiciones que he tenido en trabajo.
No, no, no. Only inside the company. Only inside the company you work. Solo dentro de la que trabaja ahorita. Inside the company you are working in these days, all right?
Okay.
Okay, so basically we have two questions, right? So question number one is, how long have you worked in your company? And question number two, have you occupied different positions? Occupied, okay? Have you occupied different positions? Good. So let's start. So I will ask the question first, Mayra, okay? So we'll start with Mayra. So Mayra, how long have you worked in your company?
I have worked in my company for 3 years.
Good. Have you occupied different positions?
No, I haven't.
Oh, nice. Thank you very much, Mayra. So Mayra, now you ask Michelle.
Okay, Michelle, how long have you worked in your company?
I have worked in my company for 7 years.
Okay. And have you occupied different positions?
Yes, I have. I have been an activation analyst and today I'm a process auditor.
Okay.
Excellent. Thank you very much. Ana Michelle, now you ask Melanie.
Okay. Melanie, how long have you worked in your company?
I have worked in my company for 16 years.
Okay. Have you occupied different positions?
Yes, I have. If I have worked in the area administrative, assisting in the event, and assisting in the donation.
Excellent. 16 years. Oh my God. That's a long time.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Michelle and Melanie. Now, Melanie, you ask Miguel.
Hey, Miguel, how long have you worked in your company?
I have worked in my company for 20 years.
Me ganó.
Sí.
Okay.
Yes.
Miguel, have you occupied different positions?
Yes, I have. I have been an assistant analyst and now I am a DBA.
What is that exactly?
A DBA is database administrator.
Okay, good, excellent. Thank you for clarifying. All right, thank you, Melanie and Miguel. So Melanie and everybody, not only Melanie and everybody, you say occupied, okay? Have you occupied? All right, occupied.
Occupied.
That's right.
Occupied.
Okay. Yes. Thank you. All right, let's see. Miguel, now you ask Flor.
Okay. Flor, how long have you worked in your company?
I have worked in my company for 7 years old.
Okay. Have you occupied different positions?
No, I haven't.
Okay.
All right, thank you, Flor. Now you ask Ingrid.
Magali. Okay, Ingrid, how long have you worked in your company?
I have worked in my company 1 year, 1 year health.
Okay, have you occupied different positions?
No, I have only
one. All right, thank you very much, Magali and Flor. So Magali, you finish and you ask Margarita.
Yes, Margarita, how long have you worked at your company?
I have worked in my company for 8 months.
Yes. How did you occupy your different occupation?
No, I haven't because I have short time working in the company.
Okay, thank you very much. All right, thank you very much for the participations. All right, I know everybody has the answers, but for this time, we listen only to letter M's, okay? On the second practice, we will listen to two other participants, all right? Thank you very much. Now, quickly, let's go to another activity. So look, in the other activity, we have a conversation, okay? And this conversation, you have it on your handout or on your photocopy, okay? But this conversation is on your photocopy or on your manual, if you have it digitally, all right? So please, take a moment, like 2 minutes, and read quickly. Take 2 minutes and read quickly. Read for comprehension. Lean para comprender. Read for comprehension, please. Okay, so the conversation is on page number 13, okay? So the conversation is on page number 13, all right? I have, please, if you have the conversation, go and check it because I will ask you some questions about the conversation, okay? So go to the conversation on your manual, please. Go to the conversation on your manual and have it close to you. Tengan ahí cerca, have it close to you. All right. Please, if you have, give me a minute. I will mute everyone, okay? Voy a poner en silencio a todos, okay? So please, if you have the answer for my question, go to reactions and raise your hand. If you have the answer for my question, go to reactions and raise your hand. Don't answer the question directly, okay? No, go to reactions and raise your hand, please. All right, let's see. Question number one. So obviously in the conversation, we have Julio and Ana, right? Julio and Ana. So question number one is, what do you think is Julio's position in the company? What is Julio's position in the company? What do you think? All right, let's see, Adriana. Adriana, what is Julio's position in the company?
The new employees.
A new employee. All right, thank you very much. So any other answer? Rosa, what do you think?
Maybe he is the human resources and he is interviewing.
Huh? That's right. Maybe he works in human resources and he is interviewing. All right, Lourdes, the same answer.
Yes, the same answer.
Yes, yeah. According to the context of the conversation, Julio works in human resources.
Yes.
Question number two. Now let's talk about Ana. Let's talk about Ana. All right. So where did Ana work for 5 years? Where did Ana work for 5 years? Okay, let's see, Miguel. Where did Ana work for 5 years?
At Unilever.
At Unilever. At Unilever. Exactly. That's correct. Okay. Now, another question about Ana. Why did she quit? Why did she quit? ¿Por qué renunció? Why did she quit? Eso quit is renunciar. Okay. Margarita?
A new home in Panama.
Oh, okay, because she was offered a new job in Panama. It's correct. Okay, Margarita, the same answer?
The same.
The same, answer. All right. It's correct. Okay, so she quit. Quit is renunciar. Quit is renunciar, okay? So she quit because she got a job in Panama. That's correct. And now, another question. How long, what is how long in Spanish?
¿Cuánto tiempo?
¿Cuánto tiempo? ¿Cuánto tiempo? How long did she work in Panama? How long did Ana work in Panama? Okay, Margarita. Margarita?
For a short period of 8 months.
For a short period of 8 months. 8 months. Thank you very much, Margarita. Don't forget to raise your hand. No se les olvide que hay que levantar la mano primero. Go to reactions and raise your hand, all right? Thank you very much, Margarita. Very good. And what is Ana doing these days? What is Ana doing these days? She finished her work in Panama, obviously, right? She finished her work in Panama. So nowadays, hoy en día, nowadays, what is she doing? ¿Qué está haciendo ella? What is she doing nowadays? Okay, Mayra?
She has some independent jobs.
She has some independent jobs. Exactly. Thank you very much. Okay, that's perfect. Thank you. All right. Now, those are the questions about the conversation. Now, let's go to the conversation again. So please, this time, listen to the pronunciation. This time, listen to the pronunciation. Carefully, all right? Tell me about your work experience. I worked at Unilever for 5 years. Actually, I worked in this company from 2011 to 2016. I quit because I was offered a new job in Panama. And what happened there? It was just for a short period of time. It was just for 8 months until my project was done. Then I came back to El Salvador. And you have not worked since you came back? Not really. I have done some independent jobs, you know, but they have not been for long. Listen again, please. And this time, listen again and repeat, but with the microphone off. Vamos a escuchar y repetir, pero con el micrófono apagado, okay? With the microphone off, please, all right? Si no veo a alguien pronunciando, aquí le voy a llevar la pista, okay? Si no veo a alguien pronunciando, lo voy a poner a pronunciar. I will put him or her to pronounce, all right? Yeah?
Years 2011.
Sorry?
Years.
Ah, yeah.
Hanson 11 to Hanson 15.
You have the two options, Melanie. Okay, you can say 2011 to 2016, or you can say 2011 to 2016. The two options are okay. No problem, okay? All right, good. So let's listen again and let's repeat. I will give you some time to repeat, but with the microphone off, okay? Con el micrófono apagado. Let's do it. Tell me about your work experience. Ah, ya vi algunas caritas que no están practicando. I see some faces, some mouths which don't move, all right? Let's continue. I work at Unilever for 5 years. Actually, I worked in this company from 2011 to 2016. I quit because I was offered a new job in Panama. And what happened there? It was just for a short period of time. It was just for 8 months. Until my project was done. Then I came back to El Salvador. And you have not worked since you came back? Not really. I have done some independent jobs, you know. But they have not been for long. Okay, thank you very much. Now, I have some questions for you about vocabulary, all right? Then I came back to El Salvador. How do you say this sentence in Spanish? Then I came back to El Salvador.
Luego yo regresé a El Salvador.
Exactly. Luego yo regresé a El Salvador. Very good. Thank you very much. Now, let's see. I have another sentence here. Let me see where it is. Ah, this one. Until my project was done. Until my project was done. How do you say this in Spanish? Until my project was done.
Hasta que mi proyecto fue hecho.
Ajá, hasta que mi proyecto fue hecho o terminó.
O terminado.
Terminó. Ajá, was done is like, when you say I am done, yo ya terminé. I am done. So, until my project was done, hasta que mi proyecto terminó.
Terminó.
Exactly, that's excellent. All right, so until my project was done. The last one. My project was done. Now let's see the last one. But they have not been for long. How do you say this in Spanish? But they have not been for long. Pero no han sido, but they have not been for long. Pero no han sido for long.
Por mucho.
Por mucho. Por mucho tiempo. Por mucho tiempo. For long is por mucho tiempo, okay? For long. Very good. So the conversation is on page number 13, okay? The conversation is on page number 13, all right? So I'll give you 3 minutes. In pairs, we will go and you will practice the conversation for 3 minutes, okay? Take turns. Tomen turnos y luego cambian. Take turns and then you change, okay? Page number 13, okay? So let's go and practice the conversation.
Yes, teacher.
Page number 13.
Okay.
Okay, let's go and practice.
Okay, I'm Julia.
Okay.
Tell me about your work experience.
I worked at Unilever for 5 years. Actually, I worked in this company from 2011 to 2016. I quit because I was offered a new job in Panama.
And what happened there?
This was just for a short period of time. It was just for 8 months. Until my project was done. Then I come back to El Salvador.
You have not worked since you came back?
Not really. I have done some independent jobs, you know, but they have not have been for long.
Okay.
Change the roles new
okay,
again.
Again.
Okay. Okay. Tell me about your work experience.
I worked at Unilever for 5 years.
Actually, I worked in this company from 2011 to 2016. I quit because I was offered a new job in Panama.
It was
just for a short period of time. It was just for 8 months until my project was done. Then I came back to El Salvador.
And you have not working a single you coming back.
Not really. I have done some independent jobs, you know, but they have not been for long.
Okay. Comienzo. A usted le toca comenzar.
Yes. Okay. Tell me about your work experience.
I work in a university for living here. Actually, I work in this company. I was 2011 to 2013. I think because I was offering a new post in the Panama.
And what happened there?
Okay, everyone. So I didn't visit everybody's group, but I could see the groups I visited, they were practicing and they had really good pronunciation. All right, so thank you very much. Now I will pass the attendance quickly. The class is not over, okay? Le voy a pasar asistencia, pero la clase no ha terminado aún. The class hasn't finished yet, okay? All right, let's see. Yeah. Ada?
Present.
Adriana?
Present.
Ana Michelle?
Present.
Angela?
Present, teacher.
Azalia?
Present, teacher. Good night.
Not yet. Darwin?
Present, teacher.
All right. Flor?
Present.
Gloria?
Here.
All right. Carla?
Present.
Margarita?
Present.
Very good. Mayra?
Present.
Miguel?
Present, teacher.
All right. Nelson is only listening. Ophelia?
Here, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Ophelia. Rafael?
Present.
Very good. Rosa?
Present.
Right, thank you. Sandra?
Present, teacher.
All right, present. Thank you. Jancy?
Present.
Right, thank you. Zulma?
Here.
Thanks a lot. Edwin? Ingrid?
I am here.
All right, perfect. Lourdes?
Present, teacher.
Excellent. Oscar?
Present.
And Susana? All right, she's not connected. All right, maybe just one more thing to explain before you go. Present, all right.
Teacher.
Hello? Osmin?
Yes.
All right, I'm sorry. All right, that's me. Oh, let me see if I put the attendance. Yes, I put you the attendance here. All right, thank you very much. All right, just one thing, and pay attention carefully here. This is very important, okay? This is very, very important. All right, let me share. Okay, listen. In the conversation, there are some words or there is some vocabulary involved, all right? Hay un vocabulario en negrita. For example, from 2011 to 2016. Or here, for a short period of time, for 8 months, until my project was done. Then I came back. Since you came back, and for long. All right. So I want you to pay attention to this specific vocabulary. Now, listen, for these phrases, this is very important. For these phrases, we use for, okay, in this case, let me get something here to check this. Okay, look, so we use for in a period of time. For example, for 2 years, for 2 months, for 6 months, for 7 years, for 20 years, okay? So we use for and we use a period of time, okay? Since, you use the specific time in the past. Since, for example, you can say, I work, in my case, I can say, I work in Universidad de Oriente or at Universidad de Oriente since 2016, desde el 2016. So it's a specific time in the past, since that time, okay? Or you can say, I work at CIMAN since 2020. Okay, since, or I did my homework since yesterday, all right? It's a specific time in the past. Cuando usamos el since, usamos un tiempo específico en el pasado. Since, and commonly a year, y con frecuencia un año, okay? From to, okay? And we have the example, like from January to November, like, ¿desde cuándo sucedió algo hasta otro tiempo? Hasta otro tiempo específico. Okay, otro tiempo específico, sorry. From January to November. You can say from Monday to Friday. I work from Monday to Saturday. De lunes a sábado. I work from Monday to Saturday. All right? From to. Okay? Or you can say, I have worked in my company or I've worked in my company from 2019 to 2021, for example, okay? Good. Now, then, ahora el then. Then. Then is to talk about another event. Es para hablar acerca de otro evento seguido. For example, I worked in that company until 2011. Then, y luego, then I quit. It's like to add another event, para agregar otro evento, to add another event, and you put a comma, then I quit, all right? I can say, for example, in my case, I work at Universidad de Oriente in 2016 and 2017, or from 2016 to 2017. Then I moved to a school, okay? And then I worked in a school, right? Then, y luego. To add another event. El then se usa para agregar otro evento. And finally, until. Finalmente tenemos el uso de until. So, and basically, until is hasta. It's to mark the end of an activity or a period of time. Es para marcar o para resaltar el final de una actividad o de un periodo de tiempo. For example, I worked, in my case, I worked at Universidad de Oriente until 2018. Ahí dejé de hacerlo. Ahí terminó ese proceso, okay? Until 2018, hasta, all right? And we have another example. I worked in Panama until my project was over, okay? Trabajé en Panamá hasta que algo que terminó, hasta que mi proyecto se terminó, until my project was over, okay? So we have four scenes. From to, then, and until. Do you have any question about these words? Before you go, antes de que nos vayamos, do you have any questions about these words? No? Clear? Very clear?
Clear, teacher.
Very clear. Like, crystal clear. All right. So if you have no questions, I have questions. Si no tienen preguntas, yo sí tengo. I have questions for you, okay? I'm kidding. I have no questions, okay? Just something quickly, okay? Solo quiero que me ayuden con algo, nada más. Okay? So please, para mañana sí les va a quedar una pequeñita tarea, pero no es la gran cosa. It's not a big thing, okay? So please, lo que les acabo de explicar está en la página 14, perdón. It's on page 14, activity 4, okay? So... please, on the same page, en la misma página 14, aplicando esa explicación que le di del for, del since, del until, then, van a completar este pequeño párrafo de la actividad 5 usando esas palabras, ¿ok? Usando for, since, from, to, or long, ¿ok? Yeah?
Okay.
Solo eso van a hacer nada más, only that. Y mañana lo revisamos en WeChat tomorrow, ¿ok?
Okay, teacher. Thank
it's on
you,
page
teacher.
Number 14, okay? So thank you very much. Thank you very much. I don't know if you
thank
have
you,
any
teacher.
Questions before
thank
we
you,
go. Bye. Any questions? No questions?
No, teacher.
No?
No
so only Ana Michelle teacher. Stays, please. Okay, Ana Michelle stays, please. Okay, so the, everybody okay. Can leave now. So thank you very much. Good night. Goodbye.
Good night.
Good night.
Bye.
Good night.
Everybody.
Bye.
See you tomorrow.
Bye. See you tomorrow.
Bye. Bye.
Good night. Hold on a second. Tenía que poner en waiting room a alguien porque no se había ido. Okay, very good. Now, Ana Michelle, okay. So this space is for you. So questions?
Yes, I have a question.
I like that. when they say yes, I like it.
Yes. What can I do to pronounce the verbs in the past, especially those that end with ed, end in ed, ed?
Yes. Don't worry. Okay, we'll do something for that. Sorry. Look, there is something important here, okay? And here we are going to talk about sounds, all right? And I will give you a little explanation about sounds, okay? So listen, okay. And I will write it here. Okay, I will write three categories, okay? Three categories of verbs. So first, let's go to the first. Okay, let me do something here quickly. Okay, just let me, something here. Okay. Okay, Michelle. So we will draw three columns, all right? Three. And I will put some verbs on each column, okay? On this, I will put the verb, for example, play. Okay, I will put the verb here, dance. Okay, I will put the verb talk, all right? And here I will put another one. Let me see which one I can put. Tell me a verb, please. Any verb. Tell me a verb.
For example, ask.
Ask, okay. That is here. Ask. Tell me another one, please.
Work.
Okay, that is here too. Si termina en K, van en K. If they finish in K, they go here. Tell me another one. I will give you the one try, all right?
Okay.
I'll write the verb try and let me think about another one. Okay, I will leave it there. And here I will put the verb visit. Visit. Okay. And here I will put the verb, let me see here. Decide, all right? I will also put the verb decide. Now, why am I giving you these verbs? ¿Por qué te estoy dando estos verbos? Bien. Now pay attention here. Hay tres formas de pronunciar los verbos en el pasado. Three forms, okay? So the first one is with the sound D. All right? D, D, D. The second one is with the sound T. And the last one is with the sound id, 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 id. All right. Now let's see. Okay. Now I will conjugate the verbs in the past. Ahora los voy a poner en pasado estos verbos. Okay. I will put them in the past. Okay. Let me grab something here. Hold on a second. Okay. We have tried. Okay, now the question is, ¿cómo diferenciamos cuando vamos a hacer el D, T, o el id? That's the question here, okay? Muy bien. Creo que tenés encendida mi cámara, ¿verdad? Es decir, sí. Puedes ver lo que yo estoy hablando, ¿sí? Porque a veces lo automático, sí. Nosotros lo apagamos. Okay, muy bien. Okay. I'll put it here. Lo voy a poner por acá. Very good. Now listen. How will you differentiate? ¿Cómo vamos a diferenciar? Entonces, vaya, en las primeras dos columnas tenemos que ver el último sonido. Y para ver el último sonido vamos a definirlos en dos categorías. Vamos a definirlos en sonidos vibrantes y sonidos no vibrantes. Lo voy a decir así, pero en inglés se llaman voice y voiceless, ¿ok? Sonidos que tienen vibración y sonidos que no tienen vibración. ¿Cómo saber que tienen vibración? Para eso te voy a pedir que te pongas la mano acá, así, en el cuello, de esta manera. Vaya. Si pronuncias la palabra play en presente, no en pasado, play, sin poner la ED, play. Y vamos a hacer largo el último sonido, play, vamos a extender el último sonido, lo vamos a hacer largo, play, play. El último sonido es ey, vaya, si tienes los dedos ahí, sientes vibración, ¿verdad?
Sí.
¿Sí? Play. Vaya. Play. Entonces, cuando sientes una vibración en el último sonido, en presente de un verbo vas a usar the. The. Played. En este caso played. Vamos a decir played. 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 Vaya, ahora el verbo try. Vamos al verbo try. Vaya, te lo voy a escribir aquí en presente para que lo veas. Lo voy a hacer en otro color para que se distinga. Ok, este verbo en presente es así, ¿verdad? ¿Sí?
Uh-huh.
Ahora bien, pronunciémoslo. Ponte los dedos otra vez ahí mismo, en la parte que te indiqué. Ahora, pronunciémoslo. Pronunciémoslo, perdón. Try. Try.
Try.
Ajá, pero try. No te detengas. Sigue haciendo sonido. Try.
Try.
Try. El último sonido es I. Try. Try. Es vibrante, ¿verdad? Vibra. Ajá, entonces sí. Vamos a decir siempre con la D. Con la D. Tried. Tried.
Tried.
Ah, played. Played. Ajá. Played. Tried. Played. D. Played. Played. Tried.
Played.
Tried. Ahorita ya te lo estoy diciendo con la ED, ¿ok? Con la ED. Porque ya definimos que sí son vibrantes los últimos sonidos en presente, ¿ok? Ahora vamos al este es es como una T, pero solo como que lo haces.
Ajá.
Okay. Good. Hacelo, please. Do it, please. Ajá. Exactly. Exactly. Like that. Like that. Bien. ¿Cómo sabremos que vamos a pronunciar la T en vez de la D? O el sonido, no más bien la T, porque no es una letra, es un sonido. ¿Cómo saber que vamos a pronunciar el en vez del D? ¿Ok? Bien. Igual, aquí estos sonidos los vamos a definir como no vibrantes. No vibrantes, ¿ok? Que no vibran, ¿ok? Bien, y siempre nos vamos a enfocar en el último sonido en presente, en el verbo en presente, no en pasado, ¿ok? Ahora bien, vamos otra vez con los dedos. Ahora pronunciamos el verbo dance. Dance.
Dance.
Dance.
Dance.
Ajá. El último sonido es...
Termina.
Dance.
Ajá, como ceseo.
Ajá, dance. Como... Ajá, entonces no vibra el... No tengo vibración, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
Dance. Dance.
Dance.
Ajá. Entonces, aquí voy a decir dance. Dance. Ajá, exactly. Dance. Dance.
Dance.
Ajá, exactly. Ahora vamos al talk.
Sí.
Talk. Talk.
Talk.
El último sonido es talk. 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 Ajá. Ajá, no hay vibración en el último sonido, entonces voy a decir talked. Talked.
Ah, ahí talked. Me cuesta. Talked.
Ajá, exactly. Or asked. Asked. Asked.
O sea que la K como que la obvio y pronuncio la T.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Asked.
Exactly. Talked. Asked.
Talked.
Asked. Talked. Talked. Talked.
Asked.
Talked. Asked. Danced.
Ah, mm-hmm. Ya entendí.
Yes. Y en el último es más fácil. En este es más fácil, en la regla de it. Porque si el verbo termina, sí, ya conjugado, ¿verdad? Ya conjugado en el pasado. Termina con T-E-D. Mm-hmm. O D-E-D, T-E-D o D-E-D, ya conjugado en pasado.
Uh-huh.
Lo vamos a pronunciar con it, como el visited, visited. You say visited. Visit. Or decided, decided, read.
Decide.
Ajá, decided. O el wanted, por ejemplo, de decide. Querido. O wanted.
Wanted.
Ajá, es el it.
Ok.
Si termina en did, ya conjugado, o en did, okay. Ya conjugado. Ok.
Ok, sí, el que más me cuesta creo que es el de los que terminan con K.
Ajá, entiendo, talk. I understand. Ajá. Aquí hay varios. Vale, tenemos el verbo fix también, que es como una K, el sonido fix, fixed,
ajá,
arreglar. Fixed. Ajá, fixed,
fixed,
fixed, fixed. Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay. Es de practicar, it's about okay. Practice. Ahora que ya lo entiendes, okay. Puedes practicarlo, creo yo.
Sí. Sí, aquí ya, entonces es cuestión de práctica.
Correctamente, okay. Ahora que ya lo entiendes, puedes ir y practicarlo. Y lo más importante es que hayas entendido. De ahí con lo demás, tú puedes seguir practicando.
Ok. Ah, pues sí, esa era la única pregunta que tenía.
Ok, very good.
Me costaba la pronunciación.
Good question, buena pregunta.
Sí, porque me costaba.
Ahora ya tienes la teoría, es de practicar.
Ok. Muchas gracias, teacher.
All right, thank you, Michelle. Good night.
Thank you.
Good night. Okay, bye.